Okay, here's another mud cave, kind of in a bowl, like depression. You can see looking around here. And there's the entrance. Someone was playing Uno in here. And there's some bottle caps over here, it looks like. And we just came in from right there. And the cave continues that way and immediately turns to the right. Now, all of these mud caves are pretty much unique. Some have features that others don't have, and some are a little more claustrophobic than others, and some have a lot more daylight coming down through the ceiling. So they're all pretty unique. So if you get a chance to get out here to the Anza Borrego Desert, really worth checking out. Somebody had a fart bomb in here. Wow, this is really a lot of twists. Look at this, like an S curve. More curves. Pretty crazy. Aha, here's one of those skylights I was telling you about. I think I see daylight up here. I think. Another big bend here in the tunnel. Oh yeah, there's daylight. Look at that. So this cave has two openings. I wonder where this brings us out. So we just came from there, and this is more than a skylight. This is an actual opening to the outside, up in the ceiling. I mean, that's huge. And you can see I think the cave continues around there to the left. We'll check that out in a minute. So that's the big hole in the ceiling, and the main channel is right down there and continues that way. Well, we just crawled through there, and it was definitely worth it because look, this opens up into a huge canyon. Somebody wrote, huge cave this way. Well, let's go check it out. kind of different not being underground in one of these mud caves. This one's definitely got its fair share of being outdoors. Little underground section. Wow, this is really just winding all over the place. That is a natural arch here in this slot canyon. Look at that. Boy, I tell you, I'm getting tired of walking. This is a long one. Wow. It just keeps on going and going and going. Okay, just crawled through there, and this slot canyon keeps going. It's getting really narrow here. I think we're nearing the end. I think that sign back there that said huge cave, I think it should have said huge canyon. I think the person that wrote that was a little confused. This is just one big, huge slot canyon, and pretty deep too, I must say. So it's really starting to close in right here, so I think we're reaching probably the end, or about as far as we can go. Keep in mind, it's about 117 degrees out here, and I'm almost done with my water, so I gotta turn back and start heading back soon. So we'll take a peek around this corner and see if we can see the end of this slot canyon. Yeah, it's really starting to get narrow. See how narrow this is. Not quite as deep here as it was back up in there. I think this is the end. Okay, so yeah, this canyon pretty much starts to peter out right up in there, so we've reached the end, basically, of this slot canyon. So it wasn't really a cave like that sign said. It was more of a huge canyon. That would have been the more appropriate terminology. So let's start heading back. I would think I walked maybe a mile in this one. I don't know. It seemed pretty long. Anyway, start heading back. And I'm almost out of water, so gotta be careful.